smile, Bruce is laughing more, right? So Bruce says, no, you can't have the blonde one. She's actually looking at a guy, and I know him. They're going to get married. I said, well, they're not married yet. She's still single. Bruce is on the floor now laughing. Now, the mother who's getting married, the next daughter is hers. So I was like, you know what? You don't want to give me the blonde. I ain't never see a redhead bohemian yet, but I'm going to start it. Let's do this. And I look at the radio, and the mother starts laughing at me. And she's like, you can't get her. I was like, why not? She's like, oh, she's a lesbian. I said, well, has she tried bohemian? So this is a resume of the average bohemian man who is successful, whatever that is. After he successfully gets his first hotel job and finally get a little bit of bug, now you gotta get the old fancy car, not the Mercedes, not the BMW.
Honda.
He gets his first Honda. And even with making less than average manager, the Honda has to have what?
Tents,
rims, and music. At this point, he's gonna meet him a UB student, used to be COB, who's gonna be a very fascinating woman getting an education. And as she's getting an education, he's gonna spend his hard earned money to support her education. That girl will leave him. He will find the next girl after that. And at that time, probably at the age of 25 to 30, he's gonna have a midlife crisis and say, wait, what the old people say? I need a family, but he said, what I can do is leave a busy set of apartments, right? And then I can start a family. Then I got some front street apartments to support my family while I'm working at the hotel. Yeah, boy. I might even get married. Huh? Now, the second midlife crisis happens around the age of 35 to 40 when he realizes that he did that whole thing according to somebody else's script and had nothing to do with his purpose in God. Nothing. None of that was probably what God intended, but that's what he thought was life. I was making bug, I had a Honda, I have apartments, I get going. Okay. Gals it. Why did you use those inappropriate languages inside of But what I'm saying, young man, is that is not the ideal life.
Yes.
It is not. The people who are coming back with the PhD is myself. I'm an entrepreneur at the age of 27. I don't work for anybody. I am a caricature artist. You know what I do for a living? I sit down anyway. I'm going to the TV of the day from 3 to 7. That's a business deal. All I got to do is sit down and draw people, pen and paper. On the average, the least I get in tips is $10. The highest I've ever gotten is $200. I meet people on a daily basis. Even in the airport when I draw, I've drawn some people 5 times. They travel to our nation, I've drawn them. I create that experience. But on average, when I'm dealing with my customers, do you understand the math of the faster I draw, the more money I make? And now I just won an international award for being the fastest caricature in the world. I can draw 40 people in 1 hour. 40 times 10 is how much? On a busy day, I can make an easy $400 in an hour. I do caricatures digitally too. I get $175 for each caricature. As a manager over Atlanta, I used to make $100 a day. If I can sit down and do one of those caricatures, it takes me 2 hours. I just made almost twice what I make at Atlantis in 2 hours of my day. When the airport hires me, they hire me for $100 an hour. Where in that do you hear an apartment? Where in that do you hear a Honda? I travel constantly. I pay for my mother's apartment, but I do not stay in one place. I'm going to Freeport next week. The week after that, I'm going to Exuma. Then I'm supposed to go back to Orlando. In December, these customers got me stuck here because I'm booked with 16 gigs. You're not going to find God's purpose following somebody else's path.
Right.
And you're never going to be a customer service agent if you're not tapping into purpose.
Right.
The people who are doing dynamic inside the hotel industry are the people who literally are purpose. They're coming to work every day smiling. Hey, how you doing? Welcome to the Bahamas, man. We're so happy to have you. Boy, trust me, you got a good trip. They don't switch their accent. They ain't scared about getting right up because that same person probably have a side business or a different business or he's doing something in the school or he has an education and he's teaching at the University of the Bahamas. If you don't broaden your spine and become option worthy in that job options in your life, if you don't have the mentality which I'm going to teach you the 4 assumptions, you can never deliver customers. Whenever the male said the bartender, they say, boy, we ain't going out there, but what you mean you're trying to work us out? I said, boy, you sitting in here talking to other men. I do not like man. You all didn't get the customers. My staff, I used to be real with them. Trust me, I show up HR, had my father with a friend. Like, I don't care, boy. That's terrible customer service. Right. This is what we're going to do. We're going to stay right here, and they're going to come to us. Yeah, you want a drink? You don't want a drink? All right, go. That's ridiculous, man. Come on.